Hello friends, thank you for being our regular viewer. In this video, we will learn the plate welding positions based on ASME Section 9, AWSD 1.1 and ISO 6947. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel to get regular updates on new videos. Welding positions are being used since the first edition of ASME Section 9 published in 1941. Considering welding positions in ASME Section 9.
They are an essential variable for welder qualification,
but it is non-essential for procedure qualification in ASME Section 9. Watch our YouTube video to learn about welding variables and their types. Please also like and share this video to support my work and help to share the learning. To brief, change in essential variables required welder or procedure to be qualified again. So, if a welder qualified in 1G position and he want to weld in 3G, he needs to be tested again. While for non-essential, any such change can be made without retesting. So, what is a welding position? Before starting a weld, the test piece or the job is positioned in a specific angle and slop to weld it, and this is called welding position. The welding positions are classified into two types. 1. Test position such as 1G to 6G, 1F to 5F etc. 2. Production weld position such as flat, vertical etc. Here G means groove weld and F mean fillet weld. Test positions are used for testing and qualifying welders and welding procedures. It is to be written in a PQR and not in the WPS. Test positions are for plate, pipe, groove and fillet welds. Production welding positions are for production welding. These positions will be flat, horizontal, vertical or overhead. A WPS will tell about the weld position, not the test position. So correct way of specifying position in a WPS is by writing flat, horizontal, vertical and overhead, not 1G, 2G, 3G etc. Lot of people are unaware about this difference and get confused which term to use in WPS, PQR or welder qualification documents. And we see test position specified in the WPS instead of production welding position.
And this every welder, welding instructor, inspector or engineers must know.
Have a look on the plate test positions shown in this picture. Flat, horizontal, vertical and overhead are the production weld positions. As we learned earlier, while 1G to 4G for plate groove weld. 1F to 4F for plate fillet weld. Let's learn these positions in details.
The inclination angles are straightforward, ranging from 0 degrees called flat to 90 degrees called vertical. The rotation of the weld face, however, can be confusing. The code specifies that 0 degrees means the weld is facing downward, such as for overhead welding, this is the reference point. Every other position as measured, going clockwise through 90 degrees, which is horizontal, through 180, with the weld facing up, for flat position welding, through 270 degrees, horizontal again, down to 360 over 0 of a degree, with the weld again facing downward. The 1G position is a groove weld test position in which the weld metal is deposited from above. As per the codes, the weld inclination should not deviate more than 15 degrees up and down from the horizontal plane. And the weld face should not rotate more than plus or minus 5 degrees of that upward facing position. It is called PA position in ISO 6947. A flat position is also called downhand in non-standard term. In flat position, plate is in horizontal plane with the weld metal deposited above. So, this welding position used to weld from the upper side of the joint at a point where the weld axis is approximately horizontal, and the weld face lies in an approximately horizontal plane. Test position 1G is under flat position. At number 2 is horizontal position or 2G. This is an out of position welding. It's a more difficult position compared to the flat position and it requires more skill from the welder. 2G is a groove weld position that involves placing the weld axis in a horizontal plane or approximately horizontal. As for the face of the weld, it should lie in an approximately vertical plane. It would be roughly eye level and perpendicular to the floor, requiring raising your arms and often resting them on an object. You can run your weld from left to right or vice versa. In 3G position, both the plate and the weld lie vertically. When welding vertically, the force of gravity pushes the molten metal downward and so it has the tendency to pile up. To counteract this, you can use either an upward or downhill vertical position. Generally, this is done from the bottom to the top of the weld piece, which is called uphill. In certain applications, including pipe welding, the weld is run from the top to the bottom of the weld piece, which is called downhill. In 4G or overhead welding position, welding is carried from the underside of the joint. It's the most complicated and difficult position to work in. Here, the metal deposited to the joint tends to sag on the plate, resulting in a bead with a higher crown.
Here, tolerances for slope and rotation angle are shown for plate welding positions for your easy reference.